do one last, bring the group back together to the question, what struck you? I don't know where I've done this picture, but I like it because it has less fire on the question mark. To me, the questions are really what the work is about, not the answers. I don't have this all memorized by a German poet who knows about loving questions. You know, questions to me are what really drives people to more honest discussion with each other, not have somebody having all the answers. So this question of what struck you, and it lights lightning in the room. This method is built to create energy in the room and not consume it, and not leave a meeting. Most people get very animated and get involved when they have a lot more time to spend with individuals. They don't come in to listen to somebody give a lot of answers. So let's finish up with anyone who'd like to go about what struck you in this round for this whole evening. You can just take the whole evening if you want. Maybe someone who hasn't spoken in either time. Anyone that struck you in your time together, these two times at least that I've been here?
I am Nicole. And I think that it just kind of had clicked for me just in this last session of the last question, which is that when I read the book the first time through, I had a little hard time really seeing it. And having gone through the process twice now, since I wasn't here for the last one, I actually feel like I understand the book better, I understand the process better, and I can see how it really works. And so I'm feeling pretty enthusiastic about this kind of work.
Someone else? Do I care?
I just wanted to, we didn't get a chance to do our gifts, so I just want to publicly just thank Ed for his wisdom. Because Ed said, you know, it's so natural to want to jump to talk about housing and issues, but if we don't learn how to do this with each other and do it really well and be brave and go out in the community and do it, we're never going to get where we want to get to. So just thank you for that, Ed. And I want to thank Joanne for her smarts, because she mentioned that, you know, housing is regional, and that whatever we come up with as a town, we have to remember that we are part of a bigger region, and that that people are not just naturally going to move to town. They may move to our area to work in our area. And so whatever we're devising, whatever we're thinking about, we need to be thinking about it in the context of the region. So thank you both for that.
I have one more.
Well, I'm thankful for having met Carter and Kristen. Where is Kristen? Because I really appreciate this generation being here, and Carter and I and Kristen, the main reason we're here is because we feel this is our home and we're invested. So that was really nice to hear. Anyone else?
Anyone else? Yes.
I just want to say that I really appreciate you being here, and I really appreciate Karen bringing you in and bringing this process in, because I am very hopeful that it is going to make it possible for us to move forward in the area that we want to. And it's really, it's to me, it's wonderful to be able to get to the level of just being people and being human and each having our own gifts and our own things without having the fight in between us. And it makes me hopeful that we can really make progress using this technique. And I think without it, we probably would just be in the same old.
Thank you very much. I really have enjoyed coming up, and I don't know if I'll be back and see how it goes, but I was, you know, engaged for two visits. And it's why I'm still doing this. I mean, my whole life was spent with young people who were mostly what we call the deepest end of the pool. They were really early on, some of them got a really raw deal. And I don't know, I just was drawn to that work, and it's what I have been doing for 45 years. And now this work to me seems to be being a history teacher, I just say, you know, we are in the midst of forming a more perfect union every day, and it really is us as a people. And there is some part of me that still believes in, you know, great, great things are ahead of us. So I live in that worldview that I think that, you know, that this, all this acrimony and all the stuff we're going to see over the next weeks nationally is going to be a little bit hard, but I just think it's just the way we have to move through it. When I've not been to Africa yet, been to other continents, but I heard a story oftentimes that we go to some of the villages in Africa. Has anybody been to Africa? Any of you? Anybody visit the Maasai tribe? So I guess you know that what they say to each other when they greet each other. They don't say, how do you do? Remember what they say to each other, their greeting? What I was told is they say, how are the children? That's their greeting. Every time they see another person in their village, how are the children doing? How are the children doing? And my good friend who teaches and is a counselor at a very well-known Quaker school down in Philly, and he has come to the conclusion, in his view anyway, the children he's with, the children are not well right now. So in a way, I always think kids and younger people coming up behind us, they're like the canaries in the coal mine. We gotta protect the young, and we build these infrastructures of the future, because we are only here for a short time. Something's gonna happen here in 10, 15, 20, 100 years. And I do believe, honestly, that what you do here over the next year, 2 years in terms of housing, will have reverberations for many, many decades. You know that. I mean, there's people that are planners. I'm not well-versed in this area, but people who plan interstates and dams and bridges and rivers, and you know, they work on these things for 20 and 25 years. And when you go to other countries and you see the infrastructure that we still have serious problems with, but people have been planning certain things for like decades. And to me, that's what it always is about. Eventually, they figure out a way to make compromises. So with that, thank you very much, Karen, for finding the book somewhere in a bookstore, wherever you found it, and thank you for your own story.
It's on my bookshelf.
I'm going to turn this over to Bill and Dennis, and thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Good enough, challenging enough. So try to find new triads. I know you're not going to be able to do it completely.
Can we stay? It feels like we should stay. Yeah. It feels like we should stay.
If you want to stay, stay right where you are. You don't want to? You want to go to someone else? Yeah, that's right.